Today, I will start the next point of this topic, that is reproduction in lower and higher plants. Last lecture, we will see the mature Anatropos ovule, structure of mature Anatropos ovule. Then next point, that is megasporogenesis. What is megasporogenesis? Question is asked for this point for 1 marks. That is megasporogenesis, 1 marks or 2 marks. Formation of megaspore from one of the cell of nucellus, that is archisporial cell, acts as the megaspore mother cell directly. That is MMC, means megaspore mother cell, and it undergoes meiosis to produce a linear tetrad, 4 cells of linear tetrad. Out of these 4 linear cells of linear tetrad, the 3 cells towards the micropylar end get degenerates and remain functional. One, that is basal one, towards the chalazal end is functional, megaspore remain. That is, in this way the formation of megaspore is takes place. This process is called megasporogenesis. The megasporogenesis is nothing but the formation of megaspore from one of the cell of nucellus. It acts, that is nucellus, it is archisporial cell, it acts as the megaspore mother cell, MMC. It is deployed, it undergoes meiosis and produce the 4 cells, that is a linear tetrad. Linear tetrad is formed. Out of this, the 3 degenerates and only 1 remain functional. It acts as, or remain functional, it is megaspore. In this way, it is called the, the process of formation of megaspore, that is megasporogenesis. Then, development of female gametophyte. From the megaspore, the female gametophyte is developed. That is, one of the functional megaspore undergoes, that is it enlarges its size and undergoes the mitosis, first nuclear division, and that is the functional megaspore undergoes the mitosis and produce the 2 nuclei in the megaspore. That is, it is called the first nuclear division. It is called the first nuclear division, and the embryo sac is formed, is 2 nucleated embryo sac. Then again, second mitosis is occur, and that is second mitosis is occur, and the 4 nucleated embryo sac is formed. Immediately, the third mitosis, means in this way, the successively three mitotic division is occur in the that is functional megaspore. It is called the embryo sac. Later on, successive three mitotic divisions, and that after the third mitotic division, the eight nucleated embryo sac is formed. Eight nucleated embryo sac. These cells of the nuclei are present both the end, that is micropylar end and chalazal end. Four nuclei towards the chalazal end and four nuclei towards the micropylar end. Then next step is that is shifting of nuclei. The from four nuclei, one nuclei from chalazal end come to the center, and from the micropylar end one nuclei come to the center, where the after that the cellular organization is takes place. Cellular organization, that is from the center secondary nucleus is formed, that is around this nuclei the cell wall is developed. Then three nuclei present towards the micropylar end, one nuclei acts as egg cell, means from the one nuclei the egg cell is developed, and two remaining nuclei the synergid cells are formed. Then towards the chalazal end three nuclei are present, and from these three nuclei the three antipodal cells are developed. Here the egg apparatus synergid cells togetherly called that is egg and synergid togetherly called egg apparatus. Here egg and two synergid cells togetherly called the egg apparatus. Then the mature embryo sac, now this is the mature embryo sac, is formed collectively, that is this embryo sac is called female gametophyte. In this way the development of female gametophyte is takes place, that is in the female gametophyte it is eight nucleated and seven celled. In angiosperm the embryo sac is 8 nucleated and 7 celled. It is the characteristic feature of angiospermic plants, and in this way development of female gametophyte is takes place. Okay, then next point, that is pollination. What is pollination? Question is asked on this point. What is pollination? And describe any one type of pollination, or describe the self pollination. Pollination is nothing but, or it is defined as, pollination is defined as transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of same flower, or between different flower is called the pollination. Okay, What is pollination? The pollination is nothing but the transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma, anther to stigma of same flower or between different flower. The pollinations are, that is the, you know that is pollen grains are non-motile and it requires the agencies. Some agents are necessary to transfer the pollen grains, and when the pollination is occur between the flower or in the same flower, on the basis of this, the pollinations are of two types. That is self pollination and cross pollination. Self pollination and cross pollination. The what is self pollination? Self pollination is, that is the pollination in which the pollen grains from the anther to flower, that is anther of one flower to the stigma of same flower, it is called self pollination. The self pollination are of two types, that is autogamy and gaetnogamy. There are two types of self pollination, that is autogamy and gaetnogamy. In autogamy, that is transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of same flower. Okay, that is autogamy. In autogamy, transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of same flower. In gaetnogamy, that is transfer of pollen grains between two flowers, of same mother plant, that is a gaetnogamy type of pollination. Gaetnogamy type of pollination is a type of a self pollination. Diagrammatically, it is shown like that. Self pollination that is the self pollination is occur in this way, that is autogamy type of pollination. Here transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of same flower, and in gaetnogamy, that is the flower of one plant transfer of pollen grains from this is a mother plant and two flowers. The pollen grains from one flower, anther of one flower is transferred to the stigma of another flower, and the that is gaitonogamy. It shows gaitonogamy type of cell pollination. Okay, here gaitonogamy about the there is no genetic variation is occur in autogamy as well as in gaitonogamy. There is a no gaitonogamy is like that of the cross pollination, but it is in same flower, hence there is no any variation is occur in the progeny of that plant, is the type of cell pollination. Then cross pollination definition of cross pollination, it is the transfer of pollen grains from anther of a flower, that is transfer of pollen grains, transfer of pollen grains from one flower to the another flower of another plant of same species that is here it is called the cross pollination, and in this way the cross pollination is occur. Here the variation is occur in the cross pollination. The cross pollination are that is gynogamy. Gynogamy is a type of cross pollination. In gynogamy there is transfer of pollen grains from one flower deposited on the stigma of another flower of different plant belonging to same species. It produces genetically variable offspring. Here in gynogamy, transfer of pollen grains from one flower to the another flower of another plant, and the cross pollination is achieved. Genetically variation is occur in the offspring. Here for example papaya, the gynogamy type of cross pollination is found in papaya, and that is gaitonogamy and autogamy is found in the cucurbita. That is cell pollination. Example of cell pollination is cucurbita. Like this, the two types of pollination is occur in the plants, that is cell pollination and cross pollination. Then next point, that is agencies of pollination. Agencies of pollination, you know that is pollen grains are non-motile in angiosperm, and to transfer the pollen grains some agents are required, some medium is required, and this medium is called the agents, that is agents of pollination. Agents of pollination. The agents responsible for pollination have been grouped into two groups, that is abiotic and biotic. Agents, abiotic agents and biotic agents. In abiotic agent, there is non-living agents. Like wind and water, these are the two agencies for the pollination. And in biotic agents, living organisms includes the butterfly, ant, etc. There are number of agents are take part in the pollination or in the transfer of pollen grains from one flower to the another flower of same or different plants. The cross pollination is occur in the bisexual flower. And for that purpose, the agencies are necessary. The pollination by wind, pollination is occur by wind, it is called the anemophily type of pollination. Pollination is occur by wind called the anemophily type of pollination. Anemophily type of pollination. The anemophily type of pollination, the plant which pollination is occur with the help of wind, varecha marfat honara je pollination hai asha prakar je plants ahet, for example that is wheat, rice, then barley, corn, barley, corn, then oat, palm, etc. In these plants, the pollination is occur by wind. Ya plants madhe varyamarpat pollination he gadun yetu. Okay? Then adaptations develop in anemophily type of flowers. That is adaptations. adaptations in animophily type of flowers. Which type of adaptations developed in this type of pollination? That is, the flowers are small flowers are small, inconspicuous. These flowers are not showy, and these are inconspicuous. The flowers are not showy, and they cannot be observed. Differentiate. It is present in group. Colorless flowers are colorless, without nectar, without nectar and fragrance. This type of adaptations are developed in the plants. The pollen grains are light in weight. The pollen grains are light in weight, dry and produce light in weight, dry and produce large quantity to fulfill or to increase the chances of large quantity to increase the chances of pollination. When the chances of pollination is increases, the productivity of the plant is increases, and also to wastage of pollen grains are more is observed in this type of pollination. Then the stigma is feathery. Another adaptation in this type of pollination, that is stigma, is feathery. Feathery stigma is present, and the feathery stigma to trap the pollen grains, feathery stigma to trap the pollen grains. Here pollen grains are carried out by wind, and these pollen grains are trapped by feathery stigma. The pollen grains are carried by wind. Varyacha marfat transfer honare pollen grain trap karnyasathi stigma ha feathery asto. Then stamens are extended with long filament. Stamens are extended with long filament and anther is versatile. anther is versatile. Versatile anther, that is, it is like this. The filament is just touched to the back of the anther, and this anther move any direction with the help of wind. When it get burst, then pollen grains are dusted in different directions. Hence, such type of adaptation is developed in the wind type of, that is, anemophily type of pollination. Stamens and stigma are exposed to air. Last adaptation, next adaptation, that is fifth one, stamen and stigma are exposed to wind, exposed to wind or air. To transfer the pollen grains and capture the pollen grain, for that purpose the pollen grains are, that is stigma and stamen, are exposed to wind. For example, maize plant. In maize plant, the pollination is occur with the help of a wind. The maize plant is stem, that is, stem is differentiate into nodes and internodes. It has the adventitious root system. Then prop root for extra support, and the leaves are arranged alternate. And this character is not essential here, but the comb or the female inflorescence is developed, and at the apex, at the tip, there is male inflorescence is present. And this is one peculiarity in the wind pollinated plant. Female inflorescence, the male inflorescence here, male inflorescence when the pollen grains, that is anther of the pollen grain, is burst at maturity and dusted, then these pollen grains are captured by the feathery stigma. Like this, the arrangement of male inflorescence and female inflorescence. The male inflorescence at the apex, at the tip of the plant, and below this, that is female inflorescence. Naturally, in this way, the pollination is occur by that purpose. The like this arrangement is found in the these plants in which the wind pollination is occur. Okay, then next point we'll see later on. Remaining part, that is pollination is occur with the help of water. See the later on. Okay.